Afternoon, friends. I hope it is well with you in body, mind, spirit, and soul. Thank you for sharing a couple of minutes with me. I am Rick Brooks. This is Live with Rick. Today, I hope you are intrigued by the title. I'm not trying to be cute with the title of this moment, Muzzle It. It actually comes straight from the Gospel of Mark. It is an interpretation, of course, of Jesus rebuking the unclean spirit, saying, "Be silent and come out of him," literally translated, "Muzzle it." The situation set up for us early here in Mark's gospel is Jesus is teaching in Capernaum on the Sabbath, of course, in the synagogue, and everything seems to be going orderly, and then a man who's very disorderly comes in and disrupts things and even shouts at Jesus, you know, "Jesus, what do you have to do with us? We know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus is teaching, we hear, as one with authority. That is not as the scribes and Pharisees. And it sets him apart as one now who speaks God's word genuinely. And who he is, what he says, are all of one piece. And that threatens the spirits, all unclean spirits. And they rise up in rebellion. I love that when I realized that was literally the Koine Greek translation, muzzle it. I love that because it speaks of Jesus' authority even in a new way. A lot of us hear this kind of thing because Jesus, you know, commands the unclean spirits to go and they head for the hills. A lot of us hear this passage and we think, well, what does that mean? You know, talking about demon possession and all that. I think what C.S. Lewis said is very helpful. He says we make two mistakes about demons, you know, both of them on either extreme. We either assume they do not exist, or on the other extreme, we become obsessed, you know, with them. And neither one is what God would want for us, you know, certainly in our walk. What's important for us is we hear Mark proclaiming Jesus' victory over all the dark forces that are in the world, not just those out there, but those in here. Now, what that means for us is we have, as children of God and ones for whom Christ has died and risen, about whom Paul said, "There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus." For us, we are to own that Spirit of God, which is the Spirit, the strong Spirit that casts out the unclean ones. You remember that David prayed way back before Jesus, that prayer, "Create in me a clean spirit, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me." Well, certainly with the advent of Jesus, who embodied all that is that we could, in a new way that we could see of how wonderful God is for us, came in that authority, that power, and he still comes and claims that over us. We, of course, are prone to sin. We are prone also to forget who is really in charge, who is the true authority over our lives. And we are always coming back, and therefore we confess and we come back into alignment, into the fold, so that we may know ourselves and with his power, walking in step with him. What an amazing dynamic of life when we come to really realize that he came to set us free from bondage and those things that disrupt us in body and mind and spirit, and to work for, to be able to speak the word that brings power and truth into the world, that sometimes does put the demons on edge when we do. Sometimes that's when we know we're walking the right path, right? When we have that kind of resistance. May God bless you today as you claim a new Jesus authority. As we sing in one of the hymns in our non-Methodist hymnal, "Heal me, hands of Jesus," we want to claim that. You have the authority to heal me, to forgive me, to begin to release all kinds of pain in my life, and to set me in the course of new life that is faithful and bold and vibrant. It is a wonderful thing, not just a fearful thing, as Jonathan Edwards said. It is a wonderful thing to be in the hands of the living God. May God grant you grace this day, you and me, that we may know what that looks like and feels like. In Jesus' name, see you next time.